Hey Virgo, how are you all? Are you enjoying the holiday season? If not, then you better enjoy because 2018 is coming to an end. All the good and the bad that had to happen has already happened, so you might as well enjoy the end, isn't it? And as they say, all that ends well is well. All right then. Let me tell you, this is a general reading, so I insist you must go check out the videos for your sun sign, moon sign, and rising sign, and my lovelies. This time we are doing a special reading for the year end of 2018. What does your energy reading have to say to you right now? And how can you use this information, this knowledge, to be better prepared for 2019? And I must tell you this as well, that 2019 looks like an interesting year. However, it starts with two eclipses. Yes, back to back. January comes with two eclipses. 5th of January is the solar eclipse. And then 22nd January 2019 happens to be the lunar eclipse in the sign of Leo. So it's going to be path breaking. As always, the energy shift around the eclipses are kind of drastic, if I may call it so, because they are kind of not predictable, right? They come in because there is a karmic cycle that needs to get over, new cycle needs to start, or maybe you have to get on a new path. People who were, or situations who were not relevant or who were not adding value to your spiritual journey, therefore need to exit from your life. So whether you release them with peace and ease, or the universe forces itself for them to get out and for you to learn the lessons that you're supposed to, right? So we'll talk about the eclipses much more in detail when we do the January readings. For now, let's get started with your reading for the end of December 2018. Now, Virgo, I think something about your personal life. In fact, this is a complete personal life reading. I don't know why, because the cards came out. So I think this is about your marriage. This is about you wanting stability. This is about sometime in your life when you actually were considering getting married, having a happy family, having a stable, steady, happy home, right? And let me say, a few people around you collectively did something for you to not get there, okay? So let's say you wanted to be with someone, or somebody wanted to be with you, and it was like a perfect, happy marriage situation. However, whether that did not happen because of people, or people came in between that, right? So it's possible that it happened. However, a few people collectively made these efforts secretively, because it is in the high priestess energy. So yes, it is spiritual. It could be rituals, could be some form of spells, curses, everything that is done in hidden form, right? So a few people collectively behind your back did something to ensure that you move away from this happy family dream of yours, right? And that, precisely that effort, those spells, those curses, or everything manipulative that they did secretively behind your back is coming to an end. It is a tower moment for each one of them who tried to deceive you and keep you away from this happy family, happy marriage, being with your companion dream that you had. It's coming to an end. You also have the energy of the Hierophant and the Chariot, which means now, after this tower moment, when the truth gets revealed, right, you are going to battle it out with them. It's like you versus rest of the world. Everybody in the world who kept you away from you getting married and getting the love of your soulmate, your life partner, all of those energies, you'll have the energy and the courage to battle it out. And therefore, the marriage will come in soon. You will also move forward on that path, right? So if you've been feeling blocked, finally, the balance is coming into your life. Finally, you're going to have the courage. You're going to be like the King of Swords, who's going to be brutal. You will speak your truth and you will be brutal with justice, right? Swords is air, and you definitely stand for justice, right? You cannot handle injustice happening to people, even to yourself. Now, when you know the truth, you're going to stand for justice. You will be in the King of Swords energy, authoritative, reclaiming your power and making the right kind of judgment and battling it out with all of these people who were standing against you or standing in the way of you having a happy family life. Now, finally, as things are ready for you to move forward, you are willing to make that effort. It's possible that because you were disillusioned, because you didn't know the reality, maybe you were not even making the effort to go towards that soulmate. Maybe the person was there. Maybe they were making all the effort and you were doing nothing about it because you were just spellbound with all of these people who never wanted you to be with your soulmate, right? Now, finally, you will be ready to make that effort so that you have that happy family. And yes, you have the Nine of Pentacles. You have your wishes coming true. The love of your life is already there in your life, in your energy space. It's just about you making that effort, moving forward and saying yes to marriage and ensuring that you make up for all this time that you missed out on because you were disillusioned or spellbound, right? You didn't trust your soulmate at the time that you were required to, but it's okay. That was a lesson that you had to learn. You had to be deceived by all of these people whom you trusted so much that you didn't value your soulmate. Your lesson was to value your soulmate. Your lesson was to have your own spiritual wisdom to make the right kind of choices, right? So if you've gotten that right now, the end of December, I would say walk into 2019 with the courage and the commitment that you will go and ensure that you profess your love to your soulmate and take them away for a happy life. Happy, happy, loving life ever after. Stay blessed. God bless you. All my best wishes are there with you. Lots of love.